Fee fi fo fum, rum tiddly um pum, pum pum!
Jill, now called Victoria, headed off in the direction of the giant's voice, for she knew that there she would find Gwen. And on a different part of the clouds, Jack, Runner Bean and the Super Sheep had landed safely.
Sorry about the turbulence, but Moomoo's only just got her wings, so she's a bit woolly around the edges.
Shadwell was unsure of where exactly they were, but they had to find Red and warn her about Jill's treachery. Jack tried to defend her, saying that she must have had good reason to cut through the stalk and that he was sure Jill didn't mean to lie to them.
Are you completely Doolally Twist, man? How can you not mean to lie? You either lie or you don't lie.
Or you lie down.
Oh, shut up, Susie Jo.
Shut it.
Shadwell told Jack that the sky was a strange and dangerous place, but that it held many unexpected treasures. Firstly, they needed to find an armory full of fish, for they were the first step in stopping the giant and his cronies, for the fish seemed to be the giant's favourite weapon. Then Shadwell headed off, followed by her motley crew.
Super Sheep are on their way!
Super Sheep are on their way!
Don't let wolves get in our way!
Don't let wolves get in our way!
Gonna find the fairy white!
Gonna find the fairy white!
Super Sheep are out of sight!
Super Sheep are out of sight!
1, 2, 3, 4!
Meh, 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 meh!
At the giant's castle, Gwen was trying hard to keep her eyes open. Arbella had injected her with venom, and her fairy blood was very slowly starting to freeze. When it was completely frozen, she would be ready to be fed to the giant, for he refused to touch her while she still lived. Gwen heard his laughter, and she saw him talking with Arbella and the Ganglion King. He was enormous, and he appeared to have three distinct heads, each one uglier than the next. But two of them seemed to do nothing but stare into the distance, as if in fear of what their future might be. Not so the third head. It was a cruel face, a face of pride and anger that now seemed to crave nothing more than destruction and devastation. If she listened hard, she could make out snippets of their conversation. The Ganglion King was being promised the land of colours, Arbella a seat at the right hand of the giant. As for Queen Katrin, she was to be killed last, to witness the end of all the fairies. Gwen fell asleep momentarily, but when she awoke again, the giant was staring at her with a mixture of hatred and glee. Why did this creature hate the fairies so much? The giant licked all three sets of his lips.
Fee fi fo fum, dum diddy doo da dum diddy dum!
The giant's laugh was heard across the clouds, and Red and the four beans shuddered with fear. They heard someone approaching and prepared for a fight, but what they saw was completely unexpected. A powerful woman, her hair held up by a sparkling bejeweled hair comb on one side, while curls tumbled down the other side of her neck. She wore a beautiful red dress, and she moved gracefully against the cloth as she passed through the clouds to reach them.
Ah, look, Senora, it's Jill.
For the last time, I'm called Victoria now. Victoria Red.
Jill had been transformed. And Big Red's cape had been transformed too, for it now was the dress that Victoria was wearing. Red suddenly felt ashamed, as if she knew that in giving Jill her cape and her magic, she had made some terrible mistake. A memory stirred in Big Red, and she knew that what stood before her now was potentially a great enemy, one that she had helped to create.
What happened to your ankle?
It got better.
What happened to my cape?
It got lost.
What happened to your voice?
It got found.
Big Red realized that Victoria did not yet know how to fully channel the magic of the cape, did not understand the power she had been given. This would keep them safe for the time being, and when Victoria told them that she had found the White Fairy and she would lead them to her, Big Red was suspicious and decided to go a different route to the castle. She sent the beans in one direction while she headed off alone.
But I wanted to go with Big Red. It's not fair. Beans, I wish I were a baby turnip or a baby bell or a baby something.
After they had left, Victoria smiled to herself and remembered the poison that Arbella had given her. She would use it to her own advantage, and Jack would regret the way he had treated her.